Hello folks, this is Ayatin Ajha from inspiredtorise.com, and today we have the Xiaomi MI Band 2 here with us for a complete unboxing and review of the same. So guys, let's begin. So guys, let's first start with the unboxing for the MI Band 2. Inside the box for the Xiaomi MI Band 2, we get the sensor itself. At the back of the sensor, you have the heartbeat sensor for tracking your heartbeat. And on the top, you have a small display which can be seen. And you have a button which is a capacitive touch button. It senses your touch and responds accordingly and shows you different details which you can customize from the Mi Fit application. Apart from this, in the box, we get a warranty card and you also get the charging module for the MI Band 2. Let's talk about the build and design of the Xiaomi MI Band 2. The MI Band 2 comes with a 0.42 inch OLED screen which is covered with a scratch resistant glass and an anti-fingerprint coating for extra protection, and it has a physical button just below the display. You can scroll through different screens with this physical button. So the MI Band 2 screen shows you time and steps count, and you get the distance. You get the calories burnt, you get your heart rate, and in case you have set it up via the app, you can also see the remaining battery of your MI Band 2 device. So that's a total of 6 screens which you can scroll through via the physical button on the MI Band 2. As was the case with the original MI Band, the MI Band 2 also comes with a silicone strap. This time around, Xiaomi claims that the silicone strap which holds the screen in place is a more breathable anti-sweat material. The last time also it was an anti-sweat material as claimed by those guys, and it is available in black, orange, green and blue colors. The Xiaomi MI Band 2 comes with a IP67 water and dust resistant certification. That means that you can go for a splash around and you can wear your MI Band while maybe like taking a light shower or something. Though you can't just go to swim with the MI Band 2 on your hand, you can't go to a high depth, but still occasional splashes are just fine for this one. The MI Band 2 will vibrate for your incoming calls and texts. It's pretty basic but okay enough. And just like the original Xiaomi MI Band, the MI Band 2 can also be used to unlock a lot of Android smartphones. So guys, I had the MI Band 2 since more than 10 days, and during this duration, when the MI Band 2 came to me, it was maybe around 63% battery life. I started doing actual review at around 50%, and then I calculated the battery life for the MI Band 2. I had set everything on for the MI Band 2. I had set every setting turned on, everything, even the deep tracking in my sleep, all of the small things had been turned on. I had my Bluetooth on the mobile phone all of the time, and my smartphone was connected to my MI Band 2 almost all of the time. And during this intense period of usage, I got a battery life of around 8 days for 50% to 0%. That means if you use your MI Band 2 on a very heavy basis with everything turned on, every feature turned on, notification for calls, messages, etc. also turned on your MI Band 2, then the device's battery would last you around 15 to 16 days from 100% to 0% with everything turned on, every notification, call, message, alert, everything turned on. Then you would get this type of battery life. And in case you are someone who wants to use it just as a fitness tracker, then you would get even better battery life. So that's something really appreciable about this device. Let's talk about the accuracy of the MI Band 2. So what I did was manually calculate in my mind how much steps did I walk. So one of the good things about the Xiaomi MI Band trackers is that even the first generation MI Band was pretty accurate, and even this MI Band 2 is also very accurate. Though you might get 15-20 steps here and there, but still it's a very accurate device and it does not miscount steps or it does not add steps while you are just sitting or idling away. It even has that feature wherein it tells you to just go up and go for a stroll in case you have been inactive for a very long period of time. Now let's talk about the heart rate sensor for the MI Band 2. It is a novel functionality, quite good, implemented in a nice way. But one of the cons about this functionality is the fact that when you have the MI Band 2 not tied to your wrist in a very tight way, then the MI Band 2's heart rate sensor does not work properly. It has to be in a very tight contact with your skin in order to work properly. So in really sweltering heat, like this in New Delhi, in a city like New Delhi, in such a hot summer environment, it might get pretty uncomfortable in case you have it really tight while checking your heartbeat. But apart from that, all of the time you can set it into a normal setting. You can set it in a very normal flexi manner and enjoy the Mi Band 2 experience. The Mi Band 2 has a 70 mAh battery, and we already told you about the battery life of this device. Right now, the Mi Band 2 comes for a price of 149 yuan in China. It's on sale in China, but still it has not been launched yet in India. So if you convert 149 yuan to Indian national rupees, INR, you get a figure of around 1500, which is around 1500 rupees. Though I'm not sure that the price, final price, would be around 1500, but you can expect the Mi Band 2 to be below 2000 in case Xiaomi wants to actually sell this device to a lot of people. Then the price would definitely be below 2000 rupees. So for a price of 2000 rupees, below 2000 rupees, I think the Mi Band 2 is a perfect fitness tracker. It has got a lot of features, got quite good battery life, it has a good build, and overall this device does feel like one of the best fitness trackers out there. And the Mi Band was a good fitness tracker. The Mi Band 2 improves upon that and makes for a better fitness tracker, though not the best out there, but still it's the best in class and the best fitness tracker money can buy for you. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to hit the thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. This is Ayatan Ajha from inspiredtorise.com signing off, folks. Stay inspiredtorise.